professionals, and once again, these couples, yards and yards of them, are dancing and competing since around about midday. So we come now to the six couples who are in the finals of the Professional Modern and Ballroom Dancing Championships 1981. And the first of the finalists, couple number two, Richard and Janet Leave.
We were talking earlier on, Peggy, about the problems for the amateurs dancing solo on this little patch here. Any particular problems for these two professionals going solo?
No, because professionals are entitled to dance solo. Many of them earn most of their living from dancing in cabaret and demonstrations, so there would not be any problem for them dancing solo, so long as, of course, the adjudicators were not judging at this time, which they're not.
And you mentioned earlier on, Peggy, the official board. Now, what is that? That's presumably the governing body of ballroom dancing, isn't it?
Yes, it's the official board of ballroom dancing, which is, as you say, the governing body of ballroom dancing and gives its permission for everything to be done or not done, as is the case.
And Richard and Janet Gleave here, Peggy, certainly no strangers to championship dancing, are they?
8 times world champion. And can they add tonight's United Kingdom title to the already many impressive list of titles they hold?
Yeah, the mantelpiece must be groaning already, I'd have thought.
And the second of our finalists, that's couple number six, Frank and Linda Venables.
Dancing to the waltz entitled One More Waltz. And so for them, it's one more waltz in the many championship finals we have seen this talented couple dance.
Finalists in the Professional Modern Championships, couple number 16, Stephen Hillier and Lindsay Tate.
And it would be impossible to sum up the talent of this young, attractive and very powerful couple in 3 little words.
Next comes couple number 28, Hans and Anne Laxholm.
Tall and elegant Hans and the beautiful Anne Laxholm from Denmark, ex-world amateur champions, must be thrilled to be in this, their first United Kingdom professional final.
Thank you.
fifth of our professional finalists. That's couple number 31, Michael and Vicky Barr.
Can they pull something extra out of those dancing feet tonight to beat Richard and Janet? Well, we shall see.
Couple in the final of the Professional Modern Championships. That's couple number 34, Robert and Barbara Grover.
Robert and Barbara are now regular finalists in all major championship events, and Barbara in a really beautiful dress, with daughter Anita in the audience cheering madly.
Just a little tease there of what's to come. Marvellous dancing from these marvellous six couples. So let's get on with it then. The finals of the 1981 United Kingdom Professional Modern or Ballroom Dancing Championships. There they are, Peggy, Richard and Janet. Are they in with a strong chance again this year, do you think?
I would think that they're in with every chance. They've danced beautifully controlled the whole evening, just as you expect a champion to be. Unruffled, everything well rehearsed, totally in control of every movement that they make. Talking to Richard some time ago, I asked him if he ever felt that he wanted to retire, having been 8 times world champion. And he said, no, because every time I dance, I learn something more about my dancing and about dancing generally, and I feel I have something more to offer.
So in theory, the two of them could go on winning championships forever and ever and ever?
Yes, in theory.
Well, here we see the Grovers once again, Robert and Barbara, a tremendously elegant couple.
They certainly are, and Barbara always seems to design her dresses so that you can see a good body line as well as it having enough flow for the ballroom dancing. And viewers will also notice that the ballroom girls have got hair decorations as well as the Latin. Now, Ray, watch carefully how well they use their feet over the floor. Not too light, not too heavy, but at all times with enough pressure to gain perfect control in whatever movement they're doing.
These are the finals, Peggy, of the professional championships. Out of how many couples have these six been chosen?
36 couples started in the first round, and those 36 came from the United Kingdom, Holland, Norway, Japan, Germany, Australia, and Switzerland.
So it's quite a prestigious worldwide affair, isn't
it? It certainly is.
To them, though, Peggy?
Well, they are superb dancers. It's just unfortunate for them that the champion in front of them is also so superb, and it's going to be a very difficult task for them to beat them. But what I enjoy most about watching Michael and Vicky's dancing is watching his shoulder line. It just never moves. Whatever he's doing, that shoulder line remains absolutely straight, and her left arm remains in place. It's really superb.
Well, let's have a look now, Peggy, at the talents of this couple, Frank and Linda Venables, couple number six.
I always enjoy the interpretation of tango that they give, the way they use their feet, the way they use the music, and the character that they put into the timing. You can see the tango music coming through every step that they do, and you can read the music through their feet.
Bit of a collision there, Peggy. Do they get marks deducted if they collide with one another, the couples?
Not really. The judge wants them to offer something for judging, so oops, there's another one. But look how Michael retains that shoulder line. See, he was able to recover and continue dancing without disturbing the top of his body at all. Continuing our conversation there, so long as the competitor is offering the adjudicator something to judge, the adjudicator will judge it. But of course, if they dropped hold for too long and were not offering anything to judge, then they would lose marks.
Now with the Viennese Waltz, danced here by Stephen Hillier and Lindsay Tate, couple number 16. Watching this dance, Peggy, it seems to me as a layman a lot less embroidered, a lot less embellished than some of the other dances. It seems, in a word, simpler, almost as if I could do it.
It is. Look at that lovely formation between 16 and 31. Both doing natural turns together. Yes, the international rules and national rules permit the competitor to only dance a certain number of figures. Natural turns, which are right turns, left turns, and a continuous left turn, which is called the fleckle, which Stephen Hillier, number 16, is now dancing. And they may only do those figures so that the adjudicators can spend their time assessing the footwork, the body lines, the timing, the phrasing.
So why then have the rules allowed only for the Viennese Waltz to stay exactly the same, and they've allowed improvisation and changes to take place in the other dances?
I would think that's probably because this dance has come into competitive dancing a little later, and they had time to organise it before it got out of hand, whereas the other dances, of course, have developed before the powers that we could control.
I see. Now, as we go into the foxtrot, a nice broad, cheeky grin there from Lindsay Tate, dancing with Stephen Hillier, couple number 16.
It's interesting to notice how carefully Lindsay places her left arm on Stephen's right arm. Not too light, not too heavy, carefully levelled, and no real pressure from the fingers, so that at all times, if he has to improvise to avoid other couples, he can place her carefully into a new step or a new position without losing the pattern of the arm shape. The strong ankle action, which is a feature of this couple, showing that the power that they have and the dominance that they have over the floor. Little bash there, but carefully recovered to that nice arm line again. And off they go to give the judges the foxtrot they're looking for, hoping to mark them perhaps into second or third place, whatever they feel.
Seen all six final couples now, Pecky, amongst the professionals. How do you think the order is going to look at the end of the day?
Well, Ray, I think Richard and Janet have done more than enough to retain their title. 31, Michael and Vicky, I feel, will come second, and I hope for their sake that they have got a few odd first placings from the adjudicators. The fight in the markings will probably be between 16, Stephen Hillier, and 28, Hansen and Laxholm. I personally would mark number 16 into third place for their dominance and power over the floor, although the elegance of number 28 will have pleased many of the adjudicators.
Now the moment we've been waiting for, the results of tonight's professional competition, the Modern or Ballroom Dancing Championships. I have the results here. In third place are couple number 16, Stephen Hillier and Lindsay Tate.
Third in the closed British Championships and now third in the United Kingdom, so that is fairly consistent form.
And the runners-up to the Professional Modern Champions 1981 are Michael and Vicky Barr, number 31. Now, the United Kingdom Modern Professional Ballroom Champions for 1981. Couple number 2, Richard and Janet Lee.
Well done. A repeat of the result of the 1980 World Professional Championships in Australia. Richard and Janet first, and their great friends, Michael and Vicky, second. We are very proud of both couples.
There's a wonderful result here at the Hammersmith Palais this evening, and I think you'll agree we've seen some splendid dancing here tonight. I just hope you'll make a date to stay up to the wee small hours of the morning with me again next week, when we'll have the same dances, only the other way around, if you see what I mean. That's going to be the professional Latin American and amateur modern. So if you're as confused about the whole thing as I am, I wouldn't be in the least bit surprised. But do hope to see you for Ballroom Champions again next week. But we're going to end this week's show with a nice honour dance with our champions, Richard and Janet Glebe.